This question is a medium difficulty GRE problem solving question. It's a number properties question. Concept tested is Euclid's division algorithm. Properties of remainders is what is tested in this question. Let's get started. If n is a positive integer, that leaves a remainder of 45 and divided by 60. Which of the following, which of these numbers cannot be a divisor of n is what the question is. Before we set about solving this question, let's get clarity on one point. When GRE states that we are talking about one of these numbers being a divisor of n, right? If let's say that number is d, when it says d is a divisor of n, it means that d will perfectly divide n, meaning the quotient of this division is going to be an integer. Integer is represented by this letter z, and the remainder of this division is equal to 0, which is when we call d to be a divisor of n. So keep this perspective in mind. We're going to be solving this question in two ways. One, if you're able to deduce something about the properties of n and therefore arrive at the answer, if you figured that out, you can solve this question in probably 20 seconds. If you do not figure this out, you're going to be solving it using method 2, where we'll essentially see if you can find one example where this number n is divisible by 9, divisible by 45, divisible by 30. Whichever case we're able to find one example, it means that we are having a scenario where it's divisible by that number. Therefore, that is not the answer. So second method is going from answer options. The first one is if you spotted this property, which I'm going to state right now. The starting point for us for both of these methods is basically what is called as the Euclid's division algorithm. Having this number n, which is a positive integer, which when divided by 60, leaves us a remainder of 45, is what the question states. Let's assign a quotient to it. Let's say the quotient is equal to q, which is a positive integer, right? Now, n therefore is equal to 60 times q, 60 into q, plus the remainder, which is equal to 45. Let's look at what kind of a number can n be. 60 is an even number. Q as a quotient is an integer. So an even number into any integer will certainly be even. 45 is an odd number. So the sum of an even number and odd number will always be an odd number. So it's evident that n is an odd number. An odd number may not be divisible by another odd number, but an odd number will never be divisible by an even number. Let's take a look at the answer options. If we find any answer option which is an even number, we can say that that will certainly not divide n. Take a look at the answer options. Odd will divide, odd will divide, odd will divide, odd will not will divide, can divide. This is an even number. An odd number can never be divisible by an even number. So 30 cannot be a divisor of n. So answer option D is the correct answer to this. So this is if you spotted saying that, hey, what kind of a number can n be? N is an odd number. Let's look at the answer options. If there is an even number, that's essentially going to be the answer, because no even number can ever divide an odd number. So this is the answer. So it will take you 15-20 seconds to get to the answer. What if this idea did not strike you? Let's run through each answer option. Start with answer option A. In this case, they're saying the divisor is 9. Can n be, is n a number such that it can be divided by 9? Is there at least one case where 9 will divide it? Starting point, as I said, n is equal to a 60 q plus a 45. Is this divisible by 9? Certainly know that 45 is divisible by 9. If you pick such a value for q, such that 60q is divisible by 9, we are done. Don't worry too much. Just plug in this 9 here. 60 into 9 plus a 45 will be divisible by 9, because 9 and 9 will get cancelled. So 60 into 9 is divisible by 9. 45 by 9 is divisible by 9. So this number is divisible by 9. This is a possible value for n. Therefore, 9 can possibly divide n. So it's not a case that it cannot divide. We find one answer, one example, one scenario where it does, it means that this is not the answer. So answer option A is not the answer, because it can divide this number. Let's look at answer option B. Say it's 15. Again, I'm going to do the same thing. N is equal to 60q plus a 45. Is this divisible by 15 is what they are saying. 15 will divide 60. So 60q will definitely be divisible by 15. 45 is divisible by 15. So any 60q plus 45 will certainly be divisible by 15. So this is not the answer. We are looking at what cannot divide this number. 15 will certainly divide all of these numbers. So that's not the answer. Let's move on to answer option C. 45. We have n is equal to 60q plus a 45. Is this divisible by 45 is what they are asking. Let's not even worry too much. You can look at multiple ways. Take q to be a 45. That will do the job for us, right? So 60 into 45 plus a 45 divided by 45. This, will this divide it? 45 is divisible by 45. So 60 into 45 is divisible by 45. We have another 45 here which will be divisible, or you can think of it as 61 into 45 by 45 is divisible by 45. So we have found one case where it is divisible. So this is also not the answer option. Come here, we have n is equal to 60q plus f 45. Is it divisible by 30? 60 is divisible by 30. So all 60 q's will be divisible by 30. 45 is not divisible by 30. So the sum will not be divisible by 30. So answer option D is the correct answer to this question, right? So if you want, you can try it out with E also. This is a little more interesting. N is equal to 60q plus f 45. Is it divisible by 25? You need to actually search for values. If you multiply it with the 25, 60 to 25 will be divisible by 25, but 45 is not. But there are some numbers where it will work. For example, 60 into 3 is a 180 plus f 45, which is equal to a 225. This is divisible by 25. So you found a case where it will divide it. So this is also not the answer. Choice D is the correct answer to the question. 30 is a number which can never be a divisor of 60q plus 45.